Joe has a question here. How does the natural accumulation of salts in soil, like the natural formation of salt pans, differ from the salting of soils and result in desertification by human mismanagement? Well, they're actually the same principle, that you've got an evaporated salted water, and the water evaporates off, leaving the accumulated salts. But with the agriculture saltation and desertification of the landscape, it's from over irrigation, and the water is naturally a little bit salty in dry lands, so you're the aquifer water, so you're pumping up lots of aquifer water and you're throwing it out liberally across the landscape to grow singular crops usually, and most of it evaporates off, leaving the residual salts behind. So you've got instead of an anti-evaporation strategy, you've got a very careless evaporation strategy, where you're just getting a very fast, large monoculture crop production out to make money, and you're leaving behind a lot of residual salts, but you don't really care. And you can't do that. You've got to have an anti-evaporation strategy with a partially shaded landscape and a diverse production. Salt pans are where water naturally accumulates into a shallow lake, and that shallow lake evaporates off. Now, over millennia, those turn into just giant salt lakes. So you've got continuous runoff from the landscape with lots of salt with it, picking up lots of salts. And that may be landscape that itself has been affected and deforested for whatever reason. And so the accumulated salts then gather in the salt pan. You may not see it very often anymore, that those salt pans get inundated with water, which quickly evaporates off, but there were at one time a shallow lake. Now the water probably just gets absorbed into the salt pan, and there may be many, many, many meters deep of salt. So it's exactly the same process, but the salt pan is an evaporated shallow lake that's evaporated probably millions of times over a very large period of time.